Hello everyone, and welcome back to another brand new playthrough of Undertale, Pacifist Run. I figured I could try doing pacifist and genocide, so I decided I'd do that. I'm gonna go for pacifist though first. I was told that if I can rename my character, if I name it something like Papyrus or Sans, they'll have their own little comments about that. Wait, I'm gonna go F4. There we go. Fine. And if you beat the game once and then you go back to the game again, Flowey will actually somehow remember you because he used to have his own save file. No, not save file. He used to have his own power to save. And I already talked to him once, and he said, "Hey, remember, don't kill anyone." I can't believe I have to be the one to remind you. I can't believe that's the one thing I have to remind you of. And then he just leaves. I'm fine. We've already seen most of the dialogue. Maybe I want to skip through all the dialogue. Some of you guys might be new to this. Sorry, I meant to go up. Diamond told me that, if you try to walk on these spikes, you can't even, like, get hurt by them. pretty much you just like, well, you can't really get hurt by them, they just act as a wall. See? Okay, wait. Diamond also told me if I wait in the room, Toriel told me to stay in. I think it's after I leave the ruins. I think it was after I leave the ruins, there's this thing called Annoying Dog, and it just takes the phone. You're gonna tell me not to fight them, right? Oh no, wait, I think this guy was here before. I've got better to do. Whee! Okay, let's see, why can't I move? I think I told her this before. I know what you're referring to, because I reset the game and you have a feeling you already met me. You were. This is the one thing Diamond didn't tell me about. And now she's gonna call me. I do not dislike it, meaning I like it. No, I do dislike it. You know, you're not very bright, Toriel. No offense, but really, I'm not that stupid. Darn it! Oh, I was so close! Oh, if only I'd... Well, at least I remembered most of it. At least I remembered most of it. Darn it! Darn it, Froggit! I'm out of here. I was close. Shoot. Okay, let me think about this. Okay. So, down all the way, up all the way. Okay, down all the way, up at the way, stop by the sign, down all the way. All the way to... Okay, I think I got this. I move along with it. Wait. Wait a minute. So I didn't have to push these rocks. Wow, I did not know that. Ew. What did Sessy know? Oh. By the way, it turns out this ghost is named Naps to Block because it's like Naps to Block. He naps to block your way. Just plugging along. Listen to that. Do I have to fight him? No, I can't kill ghosts, so... I'm actually gonna look this up if I can spare Naps to Block. Okay, so I found out this doesn't really affect my pacifist run, since Natsubo can't really be killed. I'm most likely gonna die. Ow, da 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 da. I'm gonna die from something that can't be killed. Like, something that... Oh my god. Oh my god. I friggin' hate this attack. I lost one experience, but I don't even know if I actually did. I have no gold. That's funny. No, there's two frogs in here. Yeah, okay. yeah, blah, 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 inventory. Sorry, I've just already heard all this before. I'm gonna go into each of these rooms and see what's in there. Darn it! So you can fail to escape sometimes. What's that? A faded ribbon. I don't know what a faded ribbon is. I think in Pacifist, monsters appear more often. At least that's what I'm guessing. Friggin' Lunked. What the heck? Why are there so many monsters? Yeah, don't slow me down. What the crap? Oh, come on. Quit it. Literally every 10 seconds I'm fighting a monster. I don't want to fight a monster. I just want to get through. Let me through. No, start it. Freaking stupid vegetoids. You look like evil strawberries. That looks really cool. You must. Weird. I figured it'd be something back there. I really want to read what that says. I like how they put it up there, because you know you can't read what it says. I wonder what snail pie tastes like. It'd probably make your tongue numb. No way, that's slugs. Aww. Why did the skeleton want a friend? Because she was feeling lonely. What the heck? Is that some kind of funky cactus? Truly the most sundier plant. Water sausages. Oh, I feel like they're talking about cattails. I figured they would say something else. Room under renovations. All right. That's kind of sad. Then why did I think they're cool? I literally just slide out of the bed. Hershey's. Gingerbread monsters. That is a pretty big pie. Fire magic. I'm looking at an imaginary history book. No, wrong button. Wrong button. I hit the Windows button by mistake. She wants to teach me? That face, still. As much as I like it here, Toriel, I eventually need to go back home. I don't know if many people chose this, but you know what? Fine. Ew. I like to say that bother me instead of ask me. What the heck is wrong with her mouth? Do you guys, look at this. Do you guys see that? I think I glitched the game right there. Is that a mirror? That is not a mirror. Wait, what about the other room? Is it still under renovations? Yeah. I figured I would end this episode once I got to Snowden. Nope. Now, this right here, there were actually 6 other humans that came here. And she says, every human that falls down here meets the same fate. I have seen it again and again. They come, which means they fall down. They leave the ruins to try and free themselves. They die from, as in they die from Asgore. But it's not my room, it's your room. So that doesn't really work on me. I'm gonna try and stop you. Okay, what do I know that she doesn't? Is she thinking that this has happened before? What's impossible? Oh, come on, you're not gonna tell me? Jerk. Now, the thing to note is that... One thing to note is the fact that, Toriel, her eyes are red. Does that happen when she's about to do a magic attack? Look closely at her eyes, they're like reddish. One thing I read was that the more you try to spare Toriel, her expression changes. Ow. Fudge Rooties! Ooh! Oh crap. I'm trying to spare you. I'm not gonna run away, I'm gonna... crap. Okay, these only do 1 damage, but... Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4... I think I tried sparing her 5 times already. 6. Oh crap, they bounced! I was gonna save that for Askaree, but I decided I wouldn't. I don't even know how I survived that. I'm not gonna fight you, I'm not gonna leave, I'm gonna spare you. You need- oh my god, it does 4 damage. No. My determination is very extreme. See? Her expression changed. You might think, oh, she's just doing that because she's just gonna say to stop looking at you. No! Fudge. Okay, you're not very nice anymore. Crap, I keep forgetting every time she does that, they're gonna bounce. Change again. What kind of attack was that? It didn't even come close to hitting me. Now you realize what you're doing. Aww. One thing to note actually is that one thing to note actually is when you actually leave the ruins. I'm actually gonna like try to head all the way back to the to the beginning, because it says, if you go back all the way to the beginning, Toriel says something like, someone has to take care of these flowers. Oh, Flowey's not here. I have a feeling I'm not going to be able to go back now. Dramatic drums. Dramatic drums again. Am I not going to be able to go back? No, I can't go back. Well, you guys can just, like, look up the quote or something. Seriously? Huh. This is creeping me out. Wait. He didn't say that, don't you know the Great Appel bit?
I can't even tell they're smiling. They don't have any lips. Their teeth are always showing.
What the heck? I love how they're all saying I look so familiar. Because it's a rock. How did I know he was gonna say that? You know what's funny though? Sans basically tricked Papyrus into looking like an idiot twice in the same exact way. Sans, you're a genius. Oh, I get it. When they put parentheses, they're like, I think they're like whispering. I thought it was gonna say something like, I don't know, there was like a camera on the back of it or something. One of these do. Okay. The heck? No, no. What's he saying? One, no, one, no, one, no. Pot, pet, pot, pet, pot, pet, pat, pot. This is funny. It's literally the same process, but it's funny. His eyebrow is twitching. Heck yeah! What? Two? just gonna keep making ellipses now. Let's do it like two more times, see what happens. Yeah, he is. Wow. Yeah, stop sign. I get it. I am very confused right now. And he shall arrive. And they blend it on sands. Why is there a wall there? He is cool. Wrong button. Sorry. Okay. I like how it says green and red bold, letters. Ah, wow, whoa, it's a hole. Whoever made that is a very impressive monster. I like how they added a little detail of him making little eyebrows on his sprite. Now here's the funny thing. The word Jaius Flughebrevreher, and the word search, it's Jaius Kflufubrevreher. So there's no way we can really get past it, because if we wanted to solve this, there's a U and not an E. Well, I mean, some people do try to figure out horoscopes, so I don't blame them. Ow. Ow. That time he said, hey, 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 yeah. He could say the same about you.
Again. Seizure warning. It looks a lot like Metaton.
Wrong button. I don't think I've seen this part before. Shoot! I had a little snow hat. Wait. What's down here? Okay, I don't want to go there yet. Aw, you're so cute. Never mind. Ow. Yay! Aww. He licked me. Where'd he go? That was awesome. Sans is not around. Gift trot. How about no? Is there a way I can open that? Let me Google that real quick. Here, apparently the mysterious door is actually part of the Undertale wiki. to unlock the door, frickin' advertisement, it says I have to avoid all the something of the Kickstarter's root thing. Let me see what it says. The protagonist must dodge all the freaking... The protagonist must dodge all the names of the Undertale Kickstarter backers in the end credits of the true pacifist route. There are other ways to open the door, such as editing the save data. Beyond the door lies the developer room, which includes the annoying dog who represents Toby Fox, a computer opened a bad post that the dog has made, a jigsaw puzzle, the rope that was probably using to Papyrus' gauntlet of deadly terror, a text-to-speech converter telling the player that the dog somehow programmed the game, and a dog-shaped husk of dog residue. So it's kind of like a bonus room. Weird. What the heck is a dog doing there? Yeah. Here we are, Snowden. I will continue all this in the next episode of the Undertale Pacifist Run. Anyway, guys, I will see you all next time.